हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी डिस्कस द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट इज द कंसेप्ट ऑफ क्लाइमैक्स. सो क्वेश्चन ऑन दिस पॉइंट, दैट इज द राइट ए डिटेल्ड नोट ऑन कंसेप्ट ऑफ क्लाइमैक्स. सो इन दिस क्वेश्चन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू राइट अबाउट द सक्सेशन. सो व्हाट इज सक्सेशन? Succession is a process of development of community in an environment that is known as the succession. Then second point, that is the stages of plant succession. So what are the stages of plant succession? You have to discuss in question 2. So what is the processes of successions? So in question 2, you have to see the process of succession, or the stages of successions are the nations, invasion, establishment, then competition, reaction, stabilization, and at last the climax. So these are the stages in the succession. So you have to write about the process of succession, and then we move towards the climax. So climax is the development of the stable community in an environment. So eventually the succession terminates in a community which is in states of equilibrium with the surrounding. Such a steady community was termed as climax by Clement in 1960. So jo scientist Clement in 1916 defined the climax is the terminate in a, or it is the end point of the succession, which is state the equilibrium that is equal with the surrounding. Such a steady community they known as the climax. Jo scientist Clement hai, they discuss about the climax definition, and they mention the succession is nothing but the termination of the or climax is nothing but the termination of the succession, which develop the equilibrium between the surroundings environment, and that they develop the stable community or steady community. Then climax community exclude potentially dominant species from the coming stabilized. It has the diversity of species and complex food webs, so that the ratio of community production to respiration is 1. Thus the community with balanced resources perpetuates in definitely unless it is disturbed by the diseases, fire and geological features. So at the stage, climax stage, there is the stable or there is the equilibrium, or there is the on that stable community, the food web is well developed. The production of respiration is maintained, so the all the communities will be stable on that environment. Without thus the community with the balance with its resources, and they are not disturbed until the conditions like diseases or fire or geological features. तो stable community में क्या होता है कि जो भी वहाँ community है उनमें जो balanced है, balanced resources में वो communities पूरी stable हुई होती है, वो उनके बीच में एक food web develop हुआ होता है और they are not disturbed until the environmental factors are not affected the community, like abiotic factors like fires, then geological factors like diseases, etc. According to the claimant, a climax community is characterized by the following. So, the scientist Clement is also discuss about the different characteristics of this stable community. First character is the unity. So, a climax community with a few dominant species develops under the set of factors and it remains so stable under climatic condition that it cannot be replaced by local climate. So in the unity on this climax community develops dominant plants, and these dominant plants they are cannot be replaced by the cannot replaced by the climatic changes. Then second characteristics of this climax, that is the stability. A climax community with a few dominant species developed under a set of functions factors, and it remains so stable under climatic condition that it cannot be replaced by the competition. So in climax community they will be stable on that environment, and they cannot be replaced by the competition. Jab bhi in that stage competition is formed in small species and or recessive or some dominant species, but they cannot be replaced. Then third characteristic is the origin and phylogenetic relations. So Clement postulated organismic concept to explain the development of climax community. He regarded the entire process of succession as the process development of the entire organism, which has to pass through stages of changing the age. So the concept of climax has been the most controversial issue. Many workers have expressed divergent view about these concepts. So in origin and phylogenetic relations, discuss about the climate scientists, they will be some drawbacks on this concept, like they explain about the development of climax community, but with this regarding the climax community, the process of succession or development of the entire organism, which has passing through the different stages or the vidhi changing the ages. So regarding the origin and phylogenetic relations, some drawbacks on these climates, they observed some drawbacks on this development of climax or development of climax community. Then this concept of climax has most controversial issues. Many workers have expressed their divergent about this concept. So this climax, on this concept of climax, some scientists reported that, or they reported some drawbacks or some opposite views on that, that is the controversial views on this concept of this climax. So first is the monoclimax theory. The monoclimax theory on that Clement put forth the theory of monoclimax. So monoclimax is according to the scientist Clement, they mention that the climax community is a unit of vegetations which is primarily governed by the climate. It has stabilized itself and is perfectly in a state of equilibrium with its environment. So this regarding the monoclimax theory, the scientist Clements mentioned that this climax community or vegetations, it is the primarily or pioneer community, and this stabilizes itself and is perfectly in the state of equilibrium. So they can view that the jo primary community, that is the vegetation, these will be stable on that environment, and then they can be or they should be stabilized with this environment. But the scientist Cowles doubted and challenged the concept of stability. According to him, the equilibrium state never reached, and succession in fact a variable approaching variable rather than the constant. So another scientist Cowell, they mention their views. They suggest that these climax or these succession is not a stable, it is variable, and they will be or the succession point is never reached, and this succession always the variable approaching, and they cannot be constant. Then the serial communities of Samosiers, Lithosiers and Hydrosiers coverage and culminate in a single climatic climax according to the monoclimax theories. They also mention that these communities like Samosier, Lithosier and Hydrosier coverage and culminate in a single climatic climax. So they are mention that the jo humne succession ke different types dekhe, that is lithosiers or hydrosiers, then limnosiers. Usme kya hota hai, hydrosiers mein humne dekha ki succession start with the aquatic conditions, then in lithosphere the succession start with the soils. So in that condition, the scientists known that these all succession will be start in the single climatic condition. Same ही climatic condition में these all succession will be start. This is the monoclimax theory. Then second is regarding the polyclimax theory. So scientist Tansley strongly opposed the concept of monoclimax and advocated the polyclimax theory. So another debate on this monoclimax theory, that is scientist Tansley, they not agree with the monoclimax theory, and they will be opposed this monoclimax theory. They mention the polyclimax theory, and according to him, the climax is not governed by a single factor like climate, but many factors like topography, fire, etc. So they mention about this climax, that is the stable community. So they can mention that these for development of the climax point, there is the so many topographical factors or external factors or climatic conditions are defined to development of this climax community or stable community. So the climate through accepted the importance of the local factors in shaping the climax, believed that such a temperature varying communities eventually terminate in a climatic climax. He introduced new terminology to accommodate such a temporary stages controlled by the factors other than the climates. So the polyclimax is again differentiated into two types, that is subclimax and disclimax. So the scientist Clements also accepted these things, that is the external factors are also involved in the case of succession. So our these temperature or due to this temperature varying, the communities are also terminates in the climatic climate. So the this polyclimax terminology, these are accepted, and again this polyclimax is differentiated into two types, that is subclimax and disclimax. So subclimax is in the stage of proceeding climax, it continues to persist in subfinal stage as it's marked towards the climax has been inhibited by disturbances like fire, overgrazing, etc. The pine forest in eastern United States is regarded as a subclimax to hardwood climax because of the reoccurring of the fire. So this subclimax is nothing but due to the environment, there is a persist or there will be persist the community, and on that the new community will be developed, like when the environment or the land which is disturbed with the fires and overgrazing, etc., the new community will be developed on that place. For example, in the eastern United States, on that the subclimatic conditions will be developed, and on that the hardwood climax because of the reoccurring of the fire. वहाँ पे जो फायर ड्यू टू द फायर द कम्युनिटी विल बी ऑल कम्युनिटी विल बी डिस्टर्ब सो ऑन दैट प्लेस द पाइन फॉरेस्ट विच इज कन्वर्टेड इनटू द हार्डवुड फॉरेस्ट. Then next concept regarding the polyclimax is the disclimax, a community which has been modified and become stabilized to disturbances by man and other biotic factors. So this disclimax is nothing but the community will be modified according to the environment, like or due to the some disturbances by the man's and other biotic factors. The introduction of fungus called chestnut blight has wiped out the dominant chestnut tree to form the forest in North America, and the other trees have invaded the forest. So according to the biotic factors like development or infection of the fungus, these fungus will wrap all over the plant body, so they can be developed on the or they will be perish this community and or replace this community with this other community. That is the disclimax. So this is all regarding the climax. So lastly, I will again revise this point, that is in about the concept of climax. First of all, you have to write down the definition of succession and the stages of the plant succession. And third is the concept of climax. In the concept of climax, there are the development of the, or it is the terminates the community with the stable or state equilibrium with the surroundings area. The climax is also the community explored potentially, some dominant species are grow on that and they will be stabilized. The scientist Clement proposed or elaborated the concept of this climax, and they can be characterized this climax or the stable community. The first character is the unity. In the unity, the they can found some dominant species uniformly on that climax. Then in the stability, also these some few dominant plants will be stable with the environment of that area. So they form the stability with these environmental conditions. Then third is regarding origin and phylogenetic relation. So some postulates or drawbacks regarding the origin and phylogenetic relations. So they mention that this stable community developed according to the some stages or some climatic conditions, there will be changes. Then they have also or some controversies issues regarding these climax, that is the monoclimax theory. So Clement proposed this monoclimax theory. So in that monoclimax theory, they are mentioned that according to the environment, these vegetations are or the vegetations are governed with the primarily. So this community will be stable according to its environment, and they form the equilibrium between the environment. Then this scientist Cowell has doubted on this, and they can propose this polyclimax theory. So they can make the scientists could suggest that the different communities like Samosir, Lithosir, Hydrosir, all are progressed or grows in same climatic conditions. Then the scientist Tansley proposed the polyclimax theory. That means they are mentioned that not only the single factor is affected on this climax, but the different different factors like topography, fires, etc., they will be affected on this climax. So also the scientist Clement will be accepted this concept, and then this polyclimax is again differentiated into two parts, that is subclimax and disclimax. So in the subclimax, that is the persists the subfinal stage in the mark towards, that is the climax has been inhibited by the disturbance like fire, overgrazing, etc. So the one community will be disturbed or replaced by the other communities. Then in the disclimax, the communities which has been modified according to the or become the stabilized with the disturbances of man's and other biotic factors. So this is the last point in your unit 3rd, and I hope all of you are understood this climax concept and all over the different concept in this unit's environmental botany. So now I stop here.